In the Civil War era, there were more slaves than free Americans in Williamson County. And when the fighting broke out, many slaves turned into soldiers. News Channel 5's Jesse Knutson was in Franklin today, where many of those previously forgotten soldiers were honored.
It's a piece of history that a lot of people didn't know until now. Back during the Civil War, there were people fighting for the North and South, but also people fighting for their freedom.
Wearing red, white, and blue, people gathered in Franklin's Veterans Park today to honor those who helped protect our country and helped make it what it is today. Included in that group, former slaves. It was reported that only 8 Williamson County slaves fought in the Civil War until researchers stepped up to find it was more like 300 slaves who could be documented fighting for the Union.
59 of them, 20% of them, died serving the U.S. Army during the Civil War. Their stories and sacrifices have been largely forgotten.
So today, the focus was on them.
A call to arms is what they heard. Some on the battlefield uttered their very last words.
Each soldier had their own story.
Freeman Thomas escaped and ran toward the army.
When Abraham was 19 years old, the Civil War broke out. And 2 years later, he enlisted in the 14th U.S. Colored Infantry.
But all left a great impact, including Private Felix Battle.
When he was just 13 years old, he enlisted in the 13th U.S. Colored Infantry.
His descendants were there to honor him today as he received a paver in the park.
Roy Edward Barker.
Felix Battle.
Cementing his place in history.
It meant a huge, huge revelation. Long time coming. But I'm proud to be a descendant of Private Battle.
We thank you for your courage and civic pride. Without your sacrifice and God's grace, we would not be alive.
In Franklin, Jesse Knutson, News Channel 5.
And the hope is to get pavers for each former slave through the Slaves to Soldiers Project. 29 pavers were dedicated today.